now. And if we ever needed you, we need you now. We need you now. And if we ever needed you, we need you now. We need you now. And if we ever needed you, we need you now. We need you now. For we are your people, and we're called by your name. So Lord, we humble ourselves to you, Lord, and we pray, oh, that you would heal us. We want you to heal the land. Lord, we need you to heal the land. We need you to heal the land. 'Cause if we ever needed you, we need you now. We need you now. And if we ever needed you, we need you now. We need you now. Lift it up, church. And if we ever needed you, we need you now. We need you now. We're crying out, God. If we ever needed you, God, we need you.
Welcome to Changing Lives Ministries. I'm Pastor Michael Bradford. I got a word for you on today that I know is going to be a blessing for you. So if you're watching this, I want you to like it, share it, let your friends know what's going on, because I'm telling you right now, this word is going to bless you. I'll be back.
Amen. Ask somebody else, do you have what it takes to finish?
Do you have what it takes to finish?
Amen.
I'm going.
Amen. Because we do want to finish strong, don't we? Amen. We want to finish strong. Sister Angie, give me Luke 6 and 38.
Amen.
Luke 6 and 38. I hope you bought an ink pen and paper. Amen. Because I want you to do some notes this morning. Amen. This is not going to be a teaching for your emotions. My father used to say, when he used to preach, he used to say that if this, you're going to have to take it first and then you'll shake later. You know how they take medicine, they say shake it before you take it.
Right.
Well, he said this, you're going to have to take it. He said, and then you'll shake a little bit later. Amen. Amen. Luke 6 and 38, what does it say?
Give.
Uh-huh.
And it shall be given unto you.
Give and it shall be given unto you.
Good measure.
Good measure.
Pressed down.
Pressed down.
And shaken together.
Shaken together.
And running over.
And running over.
Shall men
uh-huh.
give into your bosom.
Gonna be poured into your lap. For with what?
For with the same measure that ye meet withal.
The same measure you use, read.
It shall be measured to you.
It's
going to
be measured back to you again. Now, I wrote something down. However I want God to deal with me, I have to deal with him in the same way. If I want God to be timely,
amen.
I got to be faithful. I got to be the same with him, amen. The Bible said the same measure that I give it is how it's going to come back to me, amen.
Yes.
Do you want God to pay you like you pay him? See, the answer shouldn't be no. Because if the answer is no, then that's why your money funny with God now. Not just finances, but other things that we want God to do for us that we're not reciprocating with God the way we want him to do it for us. Amen? Amen. And the Bible said, give and it shall be given unto you good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and what?
Running over.
Run it over. Shall men give what?
Into your bosom.
And with the same measure that you mete out, what?
It shall be measured
uh-huh.
to you again.
Now listen to what the Bible said. The Bible said what you give is going to be given back to expanded. Okay. So if you give out a little mean. Did y'all catch that? It's going to come back a lot of mean. Whatever you give out, the Bible says it's going to be pressed down,
yes.
shaken together, and run it over. If you give mediocre effort, y'all quiet this morning. You got mediocrity coming back in abundance. Y'all walking with me?
Yes.
Amen. So we're going to have to look at our commitment, aren't we?
Yes.
I want to go to Romans 12 and 1, and you kind of know it. Bring me, I'm going to come down to the floor, Romans 12 and 1. Because when y'all get quiet, I need to get close. When y'all get quiet, I need to get close. Romans 12 and 1, you got it?
Amen.
Read.
I beseech you, therefore, brethren,
uh-huh.
by the mercies of God,
yes.
that ye present your bodies.
Yes.
A living sacrifice.
What type of sacrifice?
A living.
That means while you're alive. While you are alive, you present your bodies a living sacrifice. What?
Holy.
Mm-hmm.
Acceptable unto God.
Acceptable means pleasing. Holy and pleasing unto God, which is what?
Your reasonable service.
Which is your reasonable service. Now, I'm going to say something. I'm going to segue a little bit. But I was thinking this week, and I was kind of, it kind of hit me last week, and I was really glad for, and I don't always go here, but I was really glad for the old time way.
Amen.
I was glad they taught me how they taught me.
Amen.
Y'all getting quiet on me now.
That's right.
You know, because sometimes, you know, you can get smart and miss it. You know, you start talking like, you know, they didn't really understand some things. And a lot of times they understood more than you do.
Amen.
I was getting quiet up in the Amen. Church house. Amen. And what they had that we don't have is they were able to obey without understanding.
That's right. Amen.
If the Bible said it, that was enough.
That was enough. Amen.
They didn't need no esoteric understanding.
That's right.
Of scripture to obey.
That's right.
Now you got to explain it to us, and we still don't get it. Forever learning.
And never coming into the knowledge of the truth.
Am I right about it? Amen. And I start looking at some things, you know, and I'm Can I just tell the truth? Yes. You know, sometimes, you know, and you know, y'all know I'm not traditional in a lot of ways, but it just makes sense. You got to dress right.
Amen.
Look how quiet it's getting.
It's true.
My mother used to say, if you're not selling it, why are you advertising it?
She sure did. She sure did.
Are y'all walking with me?
Yeah.
And sometimes, you know, we say, well, dude, it's a new culture, but that don't make it right because no. Everybody's doing it.
Right. It does.
If it's raunchy, it's raunchy.
Amen.
Are y'all walking with me?
Yeah.
Amen. You know, it used to be, you know, when your kids were young, they didn't put weave in their hair and have makeup. And mm-hmm. You growing them up too fast. Yeah.
That's true.
Are y'all walking with me?
Amen.
Amen. You know, you had to wait till you got your earrings.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you keep predators away when you keep innocence innocent. Oh, I'm going to get in trouble this morning, Minister Crump. But I just recently been really beginning to appreciate, and even when, you know, sometimes, you know, you start studying and you start breaking some things down, and then the Lord told me, he said, you got to remember your core. You got to remember, you know, how you were raised and your homegrown, corn fed beans and cornbread. I'm talking about this word. I'm talking about.
That's right.
Am I making any sense? Amen. Just because everybody doing it don't make it right. Y'all with me?
Amen.
So I urge you, therefore, by the mercy of God, to present your bodies a what type of sacrifice?
Living.
Holy and pleasing. We want to be pleasing. We want to be pleased. We don't want to be on the edge.
No.
We want God to be pleased with us. Holy and pleasing unto God, which is your what service?
Reasonable.
Watch this, read.
And be not conformed to this world.
Uh-huh.
But be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind.
By the what?
The renewing of your mind.
The reason we don't have victory now is we don't renew the mind. We're not renewing the mind. A young lady called me. It's a true story. She was telling me at work. They was talking to this one lady, and everybody on the job got COVID. Everybody got it, except this one lady. And the one lady, they said, we don't understand. Everybody been out. Everybody been sick, but you. And she said, and she got upset, and she said, I made up my mind I can't get COVID. She said, I can't get it.
Yes, sir.
Renewed mind.
That's right.
We really don't believe that what you have decided can't be decided for you. Did y'all hear that?
Yes.
The Bible said, as a man, in his
heart,
his subconscious mind,
yes,
so is he.
Amen.
Not what you're telling folk, but what you believe in the apps that's running in your mind. So do not conform to this world, but be transformed by the what?
Renewing of your mind.
Read.
That ye may prove.
Watch it, that you may be able to test and prove what?
What is that good?
Yes.
And acceptable.
And pleasing.
And perfect.
Uh-huh.
Will of God.
How many know that God has a plan for your life?
Amen.
Jesus, yes.
But we got to do what he told us to get what he gave us.
Yes.
Does this make sense?
Amen.
So God has a good plan, but I don't want to miss it, do I?
Amen.
Do you want to miss it?
No.
So I wrote some questions down that you're going to have to answer. Number one, who are you really? Are you human or are you spiritual? Because that's where it all is decided first. Are you human or are you spiritual? Watch this. Number two, what are you committed to? What are you committed to? And then I wrote number three, we all committed to something, even if it's being average. I want us to raise our level of commitment in our lives. So I wrote this down to change. I must raise the level of my commitment, first of all, to God. Amen. Because God is asking something of me. God is asking me to love him so much that I deny myself to be the best me he designed. God wants me to love him so much that I deny myself to be the best me that he designed. God said, I have a plan for your life. I know the plan that I have toward you. God said, I know what it is that I created you for. And I have to get in contact with the Creator to live that reality. Amen. Are you with me?
Yes.
Joshua 1 and 8. Go to it if you will. Somebody say, good measure. Press down. Shaken together. And run it over. Shall what? Give what? So men gonna give you a whole lot of back what you gave.
Amen.
Joshua 1 and 8, what does it say?
This book of the law.
Yes.
Shall not depart out of thy mouth.
Read.
But thou shalt meditate therein day and night.
How often?
Day and night.
And what do you do day and night?
Meditate.
See, the church don't let the world take meditate out the church.
Yes.
The Bible said that we were the original meditators. And we're supposed to meditate how often? See, in the church, see, what we have to understand is we let them take it out because when they talk about meditate, they talk about emptying yourself. Amen? But he said meditate on what? Well, that means you're supposed to fill yourself up. This is how we meditate in the church. We fill ourselves up with the word of God. We ruminate over it. Yes. Let it brood in us. We meditate day and night that what?
That thou mayest observe to do.
Yes.
According to all that is written.
We meditate so that we can do everything that the Bible tells us. Read.
For then.
Then what?
Thou shalt make thy way prosperous.
God will make you prosperous.
Thou shalt
now, it didn't say God.
See,
you got to get this. It didn't say God will make you prosperous.
Thou.
It said when you do what the word says, you make you prosperous. And then it said, and then you have good success. Sometimes we're waiting on God to make us prosperous, and God waiting on you to do what he told you.
Amen.
You will make your way prosperous. And then you shall have what?
Good success.
So I got to be committed to the change that I desire. Yeah. Which means I got to do it the way the word says it.
Yeah.
As the scripture
have
said. We don't want to do it as the
scriptures.
We come up with our own way, don't we?
Own devices.
Don't we?
Yes.
We got a way that seemeth right.
That's good.
But the end... The Bible says it's the ways of death. Huh? We got away. The Bible said a little leaven. You know, you got a way that you think will work, but it's not God's way. And you're not getting God's result, and you're befuddled about it, but you're cheating.
Preach, preacher. That's true.
Give me Luke 6. You can tell you got to do it the way the Bible said do it. See, the old folk knew how to do it the way the Bible said it. They couldn't talk right, but they had results.
They sure did. True.
Am I right about it?
Yes.
Amen. He gonna raise them, girl. And he raised them. Oh, come on, church.
Yes, it did.
We educated and we have no results. No power. Diction right, though. A form. But what?
Denying the power there.
We look saved. We look holy. We look anointed. But no power. Watch this, Luke 6:48. What does it say?
He is like a man which built an house and dug deep
and
laid the foundation on a rock.
Read.
And when the flood arose,
yes,
the stream beat vehemently
upon
that house.
Read.
And could not shake it.
Why?
For it was founded upon a rock.
Now watch this. The Bible said he dug down deep, which means he had increased effort. He dug down deep because he knew the day that he was building wasn't the only day. He dug down deep. But watch this. Read verse 49.
But he that heareth and doeth not is like a man that is without a foundation. Built an house upon the earth.
Now watch this. He didn't dig deep because when he heard the word, he didn't do it. Read.
Against which the stream did beat vehemently. And immediately it fell.
Now watch this. And same storm, different work.
Yes.
Same rain, different house. One dug deep, and one didn't even lay a foundation. The weather's going to test what you built. And the Bible said when the second one built and the rain came, what happened?
And the ruin of that house was great.
And the Bible said that the destruction was, somebody said, complete.
Complete.
You know why? One wasn't committed to the building. See, sometimes we're committed to the living, but not the building. You committed to living in it, but not long. Because to live long in it, you got to dig deep. To make sure it's always going to be, you got to dig deep. See, just like your study in the Word, to stand in a day of testing, you got to dig deep.
Amen.
Jesus' wealth ain't going to get you through a storm. It's quiet in here now. You got to know the Word. Tell your neighbor, you got to dig deep. Watch this. Give me Luke 9:62. Y'all with me? Read.
And Jesus said unto him, no man having put his hand to the plow.
Wait a minute. Now, if you start this, you got to be committed. Oh, come on, church. No man that put his hand to the plow and what?
And looking back
is
fit for the kingdom of God.
Did you hear what he said? You can't look back at what you left like it had more for you.
Amen. Amen.
You left it for a reason.
That's right.
If it could have held you, you'd have stayed.
Have your way, Lord.
Is this making any sense? Why are you putting your hand to the plow and looking back?
Amen.
Paul said, forgetting
those things which are there.
What else did he say? And what?
Press forward.
You know what? Now, this is important because most times we can't press because we haven't forgot. See, pressing is about forgetting. Because when I'm remembering, I'm stuck. There's some things we've done, we got to let it go to go forward.
Amen. It's true.
Paul understood it. I can't serve you right remembering how I used to kill the saints.
That's
I got to forget those things which are behind and reach forward and press toward the mark.
That's right for the pride.
Most of us, the reason we cannot move forward is what we're remembering.
I believe that.
You heard about something. You remember, he said, forgetting those. You traumatized about something. He said, forgetting. Tell your neighbor, let it go.
Let it go.
You can't move forward with a backward focus.
Amen.
You can't drive forward looking in the rearview mirror.
That's right. Preach.
Am I talking to anybody? Paul said, I should ever be increasing. I'm pressing toward the mark. For the what?
Prize of the high calling.
Somebody says it's a high calling. So you trying to live a low one.
Just getting by. Amen.
Oh, come on, church.
Amen.
You want to see what you can get away with.
Yes. Yes.
That's not commitment.
No. Amen.
You trying to give the minimum effort, but you want the maximum return.
Right. Preach, preacher.
But give. And
it shall be given.
No, it. What is it?
Amen.
What you gave.
You gave.
You giving minimum effort? It
is what you give back.
Somebody says coming back.
It's coming back.
Give me Romans 15:4. Y'all all right?
Amen.
You gotta walk through the word sometime. Turn around and tell your neighbor, say, live safe.
Live safe.
Tell them for real.
Amen.
Stop faking this.
Amen.
You ought to be able to not cuss. Look at the church this morning. You ought to be able not to tell a lie. You should be able to drive by the hotel. They got an old saying, if you take the hoe to the hoe gonna tell.
I never heard that. I ain't heard that one. I ain't heard that one.
Because Satan is in the exposing business. The Bible said in Revelation 12, he's an accuser. Let me make it clear to you. Satan wants your business out. My father preached a message. He called it Satan's trophies.
Amen. I remember.
He Amen. Wants to put your head on the wall. And he wants people to walk back and he wants to say, look at what I caught.
That's right. It sure does. I remember that. Oh, yeah.
Somebody say, live holy.
Live holy.
Somebody say, be committed to it.
Be committed to.
We talk about grace, but grace keeps you from sinning. See, we want y'all want to talk about well, God's grace. No, grace keeps you.
Amen.
When you understand the cost, you stop.
Oh yes.
Ooh, we is quiet up in here. Get some sinning going on in here. Watch, for all have sinned, Pastor. Context.
Right.
You have to be careful when a con grabs the text. Watch this, Romans 15:4, what does it say?
For what? Aforetime,
I was written in the past was what?
Were written for our learning.
To teach us, read.
That we, through patience.
Wait a minute. Through, watch this. Endurance.
Yeah.
Let me give you another word. Resolve. That we, through resolve and what?
And comfort of the scriptures.
And the encouragement of the scriptures. The Bible said you can make it. The Bible said you could get through it. The Bible said, and it came.
Yes.
The Bible said to everything there is a
season.
Which means nothing is supposed to last forever. That means if you're in trouble today, it's got to pass. If you're going through a storm today, it's got to pass.
Yes.
Because to everything there is a
season. Bless the Lord.
So it was written, watch this, through in do resolve and the encouragement of the scriptures. Read.
Might have hope. hope.
Now, the Bible said that the scripture encourages us so we can have
hope.
Somebody say hope.
Hope. Glory to God.
For everything that was written in the past was written to teach us.
Yes.
So that through, somebody say, resolve. And encouragement of the scriptures, we might have hope.
Hope. Hallelujah.
That's for the now.
Yes.
That encouragement is for the now. Yes. That you might have hope. Somebody say, for the now.
Hope for the now.
But you got to have a resolve.
Yes,
you got to have a resolve. Sometimes your track record might be why you get it. But your keeping it is going to be based on your resolve. Am I making any sense? Watch this, Genesis 11 and 31. Y'all all right? Genesis 11 and 31. Tell your neighbor, I'm saved. And I'm glad about it. How many glad about it? How many everybody know? Okay, because that got faint. They know you're saved.
Amen. Amen. They know.
Not on Tuesdays.
Not
how many they guessing? Now this is important. You got to work out.
The salvation fulfilled.
Y'all listening to me this morning? You got to stop slipping,
amen,
tipping, and dipping. It's old school stuff. Quiet in here this morning. You got to be committed to God.
Hallelujah.
Like Peter said, where are we going to go?
Amen.
There's no other place for us.
That's right.
I talked to Sister Marilyn, and y'all know what she's been through, but the one thing she makes clear, I got to come to church.
Yes.
You can't go through trauma and skip church.
That's right.
How you cutting church? How you so hurt you need a break from church?
Right. That's where your soul is.
Something's wrong.
Okay.
Y'all need to hear this. Something's wrong when you need a break from church. And this young generation, they take vacations from church as much as they can. Am I telling the truth?
Yeah.
They look for the Sunday to skip. All y'all got your kids in AAU, that was demonic. I'm going to say it. You know, got the kids playing sports on Sundays.
Oh.
See, Satan did that on purpose.
Mm-hmm.
Your son can't hoop. Just bring him on to church. You just clap it. Come on, Johnny. Come on. He can't hoop. Y'all understand what I'm saying? Chick-fil-A shuts down.
Sure does.
They make more money than anybody.
Yeah.
But they remember.
Because
they believe on him.
Yeah.
As the
scriptures have said.
You can't give God a day.
Preach.
You can't give God a day. Church 2 hours. You got 168 hours in a week.
Hallelujah.
You can't put two aside.
It's true.
You pick the two that God wants to bless you to skip.
Hallelujah.
Is this making any sense? You don't believe on him. Like the scripture.
No.
That's why ain't nothing coming out of your belly. You don't have flow.
That's right.
Oh, see, y'all.
Oh, yes. Oh,
yes. Is this making any sense? You ain't got flow. He said, if you believe only the scripture said, out of your belly shall flow rivers of what?
Living water.
Living water. You wonder why your faucet is stopped up. You ain't got flow.
True.
What's flow? The anointing. The Bible says the anointing gives us the ability to break. You can't break yokes with no flow. Tell your neighbor, you need flow.
You need flow.
How many want flow? Man. Flow is the word, baby. Yes. You need to know the word.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Genesis 11:31. Read a little faster, Sister Angie. You know, I always blame her when I take long. Let's go.
And Terah took Abram his son.
Yes.
And Lot, the son of Haran, his son's son.
Yes.
And Sarai, his daughter-in-law.
Yes.
His son Abram's wife.
Yes.
And they went forth with them from Ur of the Chaldees.
Where?
To go into the land of Canaan.
They're heading to Canaan. Read.
And they came unto Haran and dwelt there.
Read.
And the days of Terah
were
205 years. And Terah died in Haran.
Where did he die?
In Haran.
That is interesting because he's supposed to have been going to Canaan.
Wow.
But when they came to Haran, the Bible said they did what? They did what?
Dwell.
Where are you settling at?
Amen. It's true.
Where did he tell you to go? And where are you settling? Some of you all, you're dying short of where you're supposed to be going.
Amen.
On your way to the promised land, but you stop somewhere else to die. Is that what we're doing?
That's good.
We dying in foreign land?
That's strange.
Is that what we're doing? Because we don't have the resolve to go all the way?
Come on. Make it plain.
Watch this, Genesis 12:5.
And Abram took Sarai his wife. And Lot his brother's son.
Yes.
And all their substance that they had gathered.
Breathe.
And the souls that they had gotten in Haran.
Yes.
And they went forth to go into the land of Canaan. And into the land of Canaan they came.
Now, Abram had resolve. I'm not going to die where I'm not supposed to die. I'm not going to die because I'm comfortable. Most of us, comfortableness is killing us.
Amen.
You're not in the perfect will. You're in the permissive one. See, the journey is the permissive will, but the destination is the perfect will. Where are you on your way to? Because he that begun a good work... Oh, the word's flowing this morning. He that has begun a good work? He didn't tell you to go somewhere to die in the middle. If he told you to go there, you got strength to make it.
It's good. That's so good.
Because he completes what he starts.
Yeah.
He's the great finisher.
Yeah.
When he hung on the cross, he said, it is. I didn't come here for them to push me off a cliff. Oh, some of y'all missed that. I came to die by the way of the cross.
That's right. That's right, preacher.
Some of us, because we've done good things, we're trying to rest on our laurels. Yeah, you got a good resume.
Preacher.
But your resolve is weak.
Yes.
The three Hebrew boys, when they didn't eat the food, that was a test. Later on, the king said, anybody who hears the music, you're going to have to bow down to this music or we're going to kill you. Now, the three Hebrews could have said, look, you know what? We got a good resume, king. We've already showed you that God is God. But watch this. That wasn't about the resolve. Are you willing to go all the way? Because the first test is not the last one. The test sets you up for the trial. Because there's going to come a point in your life where God wants to show people that he's God.
Hallelujah.
And that's when you're going to have a resolve. And what you did in the past ain't going to help you in that moment. Yeah, king, we denied you about the food, but that ain't going to help us live about this bowing down. Am I helping anybody? Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane. He says, if it be
thy will,
let this
cup.
Watch this. This is a difficult and challenging moment.
Yes, it is. Amen.
I don't want to go through it. Watch this, how we planned it. I know I came here to die.
That's right.
But being in the moment is more tougher than I thought it'd be. He could have told God, wait a minute, I need to let you know something about me. You got me in the garden, but I'm the guy that healed the sick. I'm the guy that raised the dead. I'm the guy that opened blinded eyes. Wait a minute, did you look at my resume? Do you know what I've done?
Yes,
I'm the guy that cast the demons out of Legion. I'm the guy that did all of these things. God said it ain't about the resume.
Yes.
You at the point of resolve.
Hallelujah.
What are you going to do right now? Some of y'all, you got to get it. Live and save yesterday ain't enough. Are you holy now?
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Are you standing strong now? So Jesus looked at him and said, nevertheless. Somebody said, not my will.
Not my will.
But what?
Thy will be done.
He said, I'm committed to the whole journey.
Amen. Yes.
Because my resume ain't going to help me on the cross.
Amen. Glory.
Did y'all hear that? How you sang last Sunday ain't going to help you Monday.
No.
Are you committed for next level living? Do you want a better life? Are you committed to the change that you say you want? Well, it's going to call for a different output. You got what you got doing what you did. But to get more, you're going to have to give more. Give and it. Don't skip it. Because it is what you gave. He's going to give back every, Genesis 1 and 12, every seed shall produce after what? It's a law of germination that what is produced, what seed is planted, it must come back and it must be the same thing. In abundance. So if you're stingy, it's coming back. In abundance. Give and it. What is it? Are you proud of your offering? I'm talking about your it. Are you proud of your it? You proud of how you're handling your house? Your it? You proud of how you're handling your spouse? Your it? You proud of how you're handling your finances? Let me tell you something. When God judges us, I'm talking about us, okay? When he judges us, he's only going to judge you for one thing, how you managed it. Amen. You know, all y'all got this, and they're going to put the evil on one scale and the good on the other scale, and if the good outweighs, no, it don't work like that. Oh, y'all didn't hear me. If you ain't got God in, you don't matter how much good you did. Right.
Absolutely.
Oh, somebody missed that. See, a lot of good people going to hell.
That's right.
Because this ain't based on good.
No.
It's based on, did you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? Though I give my body to be burned. It don't matter what you do. If you don't have a relationship with God, you're lost.
That's right.
Isn't it interesting? And I'm closing. Isn't it interesting that Saul had a better moral life than David? Somebody catch that on the way home. But he didn't have relationship. Somebody got that. See, good folk going to hell. Y'all hearing me? A lot of people, I'm just trying to make sure my good outweigh my bad. My dad told me before he met Christ, that's what he used to say. I just want to make sure my good outweighs my bad. And God had to have a conversation with him.
Yeah, that's what he thought.
C.S. Lewis says something, and I'm closing with this. He said, you never go to heaven with a hell teddy bear. He said, and you never go to hell, listen to this, with a heaven teddy bear. What did he mean? Here's what he meant. He said, if you go to heaven, you was all God. And if you go to hell, you was all hell. Because God is only taken holy. Oh, yeah, quiet up in there.
That's good.
I said he's only taking
what's
holy. So when you got saved, the blood covered. Remember when they went in the tabernacle? And the tabernacle had to make sure that it was filled with smoke? Because God didn't want to see no flesh? That was a foreshadowing of what he did on the cross. Y'all remember that? How they had the bells on the hems of the garments? And the priest would walk in and they would have a rope tied around his waist? Come on, y'all remember this?
I remember.
And when they would walk in, the bells would be ringing because they was going to the altar and lighting the candles. And y'all know what I'm talking about? And watch this, as long as the bells was ringing, they were still alive.
Right, absolutely.
But you better make sure it's smoky. Because if he saw flesh, we didn't hear no more bells. That man pulled them out, boys.
That's right.
Am I right? This year, before you get into your 22, you raising your level of commitment to God. And you ain't going to be talking about what you did on your resume. Because it don't matter. Your last success most times is your enemy. Most times people never go further because they rested on what they did yesterday. And they think yesterday speaks forever, but it doesn't.
No. Amen.
Does this make sense?
Yeah.
Jane, it's not about your resume.
It's not about my resume.
I know you did some good things. It's about can you go all the way?
Hallelujah.
Haran or Canaan? It's a choice. Do you die in comfortability and mediocrity? Or do you tell God, I'm going all the way? I want to make you proud. How many want to make God proud? Stand to your feet. Give the Lord a hand of praise.
Hey, thank you guys so much for joining our live feed and broadcast. We do appreciate your time, but we are eager and excited that you're joining our community, our faithful community of followers and believers, people who are life changers, who are world changers. And so what we're going to ask you to do is if you have a desire to give because this message is feeding you and providing everything that you need to help you get to that next level, to present your best self, then what we're going to ask you to do is partner with us. No gift is too big or too small in the kingdom of God that is going to be utilized to reach the untaught, the unchurched, and the uncommitted. So we thank you so much for what you're doing, what you've done, and what you will continue to do as a life changer. Thank you so much. Remember, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord show you his favor and give you his peace. God bless you.